Welcome students. In our last class, we discussed about aerobic respiration. So aerobic respiration means respiration which takes place in the presence of oxygen. Whereas in anaerobic respiration, the respiration means takes place in the absence of oxygen. So anaerobic respiration means absence or lack of oxygen. Certain bacteria, fungi and everything, it may take place their respiration in the absence of oxygen. The first step, glycolysis, which is common to both anaerobic as well as aerobic respiration. So organisms that can respire in the absence of oxygen are called anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration we can also known as fermentation. So fermentation means anaerobic respiration. There are three types of fermentation, that is lactic acid fermentation, alcoholic fermentation, finally mixed fermentation. So there are three types of fermentation, that is lactic acid fermentation, then alcoholic fermentation and mixed fermentation. First we can look alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation. So alcoholic fermentation means the pyruvic acid, that is glycolysis is same for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So the byproduct of the glycolysis is the glucose is converted to the pyruvate, and the pyruvate is converted to ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. So during alcoholic fermentation, the glucose which is converted to pyruvate, glucose molecule which is converted to pyruvate by a series of process. In this, NADH, two NADH molecules and two ATPs are produced. So we can ignore the ATP because two ATPs are consumed in glycolysis. So we just add only two NADH molecules, and this pyruvate is converted to ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. So this pyruvate is converted to ethyl alcohol, that's why it is called as alcoholic fermentation. Ethyl alcohol plus carbon dioxide, ethyl alcohol plus carbon dioxide. So mainly this alcoholic fermentation may take place in the cells of root which are in waterlogged soil. So certain plants which are in waterlogged soil may occur the alcoholic fermentation, and also some yeast species the alcoholic fermentation may take place. Actually how this happens is the pyruvate is converted to acetaldehyde in the presence of, that is decarboxylation of pyruvic acid takes place and it forms acetaldehyde in the presence of pyruvate decarboxylase. So alcoholic fermentation means the pyruvate which converted to acetaldehyde, that is decarboxylation of pyruvate is taken by the presence of pyruvate decarboxylase. And the acetaldehyde is converted to ethyl alcohol and ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide in the presence of alcohol dehydrogenase, in the presence of enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase. So the pyruvate which is converted to acetaldehyde in the presence of enzyme pyruvate decarboxylase, then the acetaldehyde is converted to ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide in the presence of enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase. Okay, this is alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation may occur in the cells of root which are in waterlogged soils and also some yeast species. Now, there are some industrial uses for this ethyl alcohol fermentation. In bakeries, we are using this type or this technique for preparing bread, cake and biscuits. And also in beverage industries, we are using this alcoholic fermentation for preparing wine and some alcohol drinks. Also, in the production of vinegar and in tanning, curing of leather, we are using this alcohol fermentation. And ethanol is used to make gasohol, that is a fuel that is used for car in Brazil. So, these are the industrial use of alcoholic fermentation. Now we are moving to lactic acid fermentation. Lactic acid fermentation. Lactic acid fermentation. It is simply the conversion of pyruvate into lactic acid. Conversion of pyruvate into lactic acid in the presence of lactic acid dehydrogenase. Lactic acid dehydrogenase. So the pyruvate is converted to lactic acid in the presence of lactic acid dehydrogenase. This is simply lactic acid fermentation. Now we are moving to mixed fermentation. Mixed fermentation. Mixed fermentation is found mainly in the Enterobacteriaceae. Mainly it is found in the family Enterobacteriaceae. And it forms lactic acid, ethanol, formic acid and gases like carbon dioxide and H2. That is both. Mixed means both. Both lactic acid as well as alcoholic fermentation may take place. So it's called mixed fermentation. And formation of lactic acid, ethanol, formic acid and gases like carbon dioxide and H2O takes place. So gases like acid like formic acid, alcohol, lactic acid and gases like carbon dioxide and H2O may form during mixed fermentation. So these are about the mixed fermentation. Now we can discuss what are the characteristics of anaerobic respiration. So anaerobic respiration means respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen, and there are three types of anaerobic respiration. We called as anaerobic respiration at fermentation. So there are three types, that is alcoholic fermentation, lactic acid fermentation and mixed fermentation. Now what are the characteristics of anaerobic respiration? Anaerobic respiration is less efficient than aerobic respiration. So it is less efficient compared to aerobic respiration. It is less efficient. Then the limited number of ATP molecule is generated per glucose molecule. So limited number of ATP is produced per glucose molecules. But in aerobic there are 36 molecules are produced per ATP molecules. Now The third one is the production of carbon dioxide is a characteristic of anaerobic respiration and it is used for carbon fixation in photosynthesis. So the produced carbon dioxide may use in carbon fixation during photosynthesis. So these are the characteristics of anaerobic respiration. These are the characteristics of anaerobic respiration. So students, in this chapter 14 we reach our last topic, that is pentose phosphate pathway, that is PPP pathway. So PPP pathway, otherwise called as pentose phosphate pathway, also known as phosphogluconate pathway. Pentose phosphate pathway, also known as phosphogluconate pathway. So it is an alternate way for the breakdown of glucose. So glucose can be breakdown using glycolysis, or it is the alternate way for breakdown of glucose. It is pentose phosphate pathway. It occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. It occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. So pentose phosphate pathway is the alternate way to break down the glucose molecules rather than glycolysis, and it occurs in the cytoplasm. Pentose phosphate pathway, also known as phosphogluconate pathway. In pentose phosphate pathway there is two phase. Okay, there is two phase. First one, oxidative phase. Second one, non-oxidative phase. Oxidative phase and non-oxidative phase. So pentose phosphate pathway includes two phases, that is oxidative phase and non-oxidative phase. In oxidative phase, the six molecule of six carbon, that is glucose 6-phosphate, is converted to six molecule of 5-carbon compound, that is ribulose 5-phosphate. So this is the oxidative phase. During oxidative phase, the 6-carbon compound, 6-molecule of 6-carbon compound glucose 6-phosphate is converted to 6-molecule of 5-carbon compound ribulose 5-phosphate. So glucose is converted to glucose 6-phosphate in the process glycolysis, and 6-glucose-6-phosphate, that is 6-molecule of glucose-6-phosphate, is entered to the pentose phosphate pathway. This 6-molecule of glucose-6-phosphate is converted to 6-molecule of 6-phosphoglucolactone. So 6-molecule of glucose-6-phosphate is converted to 6-molecule of 6-phosphoglucolactone. In the presence of enzyme, glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase convert the glucose 6-phosphate into 6-phosphoglucolactone. And this 6-phosphoglucolactone is converted to 6-phosphogluconate in the presence of enzyme lactonase. So the 6-phosphoglucolactone is converted to 6-phosphogluconate in the presence of enzyme lactonase. Then this 6-phosphogluconate is converted to a 5-carbon compound, that is ribulose 5-phosphate. So the 6-molecule of 6-phosphogluconate is converted to 6-molecule of 5-carbon compound, that is ribulose 5-phosphate, in the presence of enzyme 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase. So these are the oxidative phase. And during non-oxidative phase, the ribulose 5-phosphate, it is converted to various intermediate compounds. So the 5-carbon compound ribulose 5-phosphate is converted to several intermediate compounds, which include 3-carbon, 4-carbon, 5-carbon, 6-carbon. So, and from that intermediate compound, it converted to fructose 6-phosphate. 5 molecules of fructose-6-phosphate. And this fructose-6-phosphate, the 6-carbon compound fructose-6-phosphate, is again isomerized to glucose-6-phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphohexoisomerase. So this cycle may continue. So rather than glycolysis, glucose has an alternative pathway for breakdown, that is pentose phosphate pathway. So it is occur in the cytoplasm. It includes oxidative and non-oxidative phases. During oxidative phases, the 6 molecule of 6 carbon compound glucose-6-phosphate is converted to 6-phosphoglucolactone with the help of enzyme glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And this 6 molecule of 6-phosphoglucolactone is converted to 6 molecule of 6-phosphogluconate and with the help of enzyme lactonase. Then 6 molecule of 6-phosphogluconate is converted to 6 molecule of 5-carbon compound, that is rubulose-5-phosphate, with the help of enzyme 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase. And these rubulose-5-phosphate is converted to several intermediate compounds, which include 3-carbon compound, 4-carbon compound, 5-carbon compound, several 6-carbon compounds. From these compounds, it may converted to 6-carbon compound, 5 molecule of fructose-6-phosphate. And these fructose-6-phosphate is isomerized into glucose-6-phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphohexoisomerase. So these are about pentose phosphate pathway. And in this pathway, several energy molecules are produced, that is NADPH form. So energy molecules are produced in the form of NADPH. So one energy molecule is produced here and one is here. So energy molecule are also produced in the form of NADPH form. Now if we look the significance, of pentose phosphate pathway, that is the generation of two important products, that is NADPH and pentose sugars, which play an important role in anabolic respiration, that is rubulose-5-phosphate is produced and several NADPH molecules are produced. So these two molecules play vital role in anabolic reaction. And the coenzyme NADPH, is generated, which is used in the reductive biosynthesis and counter damaging of the oxygen free radicals. So NADPH is generated and it is used in the reductive biosynthesis and counter damaging effects of oxygen free radicals. And the ribulose-5-phosphate and its derivatives, that is several intermediates that are essential for the DNA, RNA, ATP, NAD plus FAD and coenzyme A synthesis. Then the erythrose, which is used for the synthesis of anthocyanin, lignin and other aromatic compounds. That is erythrose means it is a derivative from the rubulose-5-phosphate and it helps in synthesis of anthocyanin, lignin and other aromatic compounds. And also the pentose phosphate pathway plays an important role on fixation of carbon dioxide in photosynthesis through RUBP. So these are the significance of pentose phosphate pathway. So by this pentose phosphate pathway, we are concluding our chapter respiration. So it's a small chapter, but important questions have arisen from this chapter. So you guys all go through it thoroughly. So in our next class, we will discuss about transport in plants. Okay, transport in plants.